my goodness. Look at all of the ice cream. Oh my goodness. Oh. Ice cream.
Hey guys, I am Mark. Steven has the evening off tonight, and this is Smokey, Steve, and Mark. Oh, yes it is. Oh, welcome or welcome back. It's so nice to see you. How are you? Oh my gosh, we have such a fun episode tonight. I tell you what, I was so let down by not being able to spend time with you on Mondays with Mark last Monday because we had lost all that footage. But I get to make it up tonight. So cool, so cool. Tonight I'm going to share with you one of my all-time favorite recipe hacks. For real, we're going to make an ice cream cake tonight. But first, of course, we gotta check in, see how you're doing, how are you? We made it to the weekend. It's Friday. Happy Friday, TGIF. Oh my goodness, what a long week it was, right? I don't know if you can relate, but man, this was a long week, let me tell you. I'm so happy that it's Friday, and I'm even more happier to be doing this recipe tonight because I've been wanting to show it to you for quite some time, and originally we were going to do it last Monday, but Steven inadvertently had deleted all of the footage that we filmed. We made a complete dinner and everything, and it was all gone, but we'll get to make it up tonight, you know. So I'm also excited because we still get to have that time together, just you and I, our little QT, you know. So yeah, I hope you had a great week, and I hope you have some fun plans for the weekend coming up. You know, this is one of those recipes that would be perfect for the weekend. It's great for the summer because if it's like how it is here where you're at, it's extremely hot. We went, it just skyrocketed up again. It's 96 right now. And it's going to be this way for the entire weekend up until next Tuesday. So, you know, I don't know. Ice cream sounds pretty good right about now, you know? I don't know. But, so, you know, what do they say? Ice cream, you scream, we all scream for ice cream. That must mean something, and it does, because July is National Ice Cream Month here in the States, and National Ice Cream Day is this Sunday. So, I mean, how more appropriate than to make an ice cream cake, right? So, you know me, I had to do a little bit of research because, I knew there had to be some kind of interesting fact about National Ice Cream Day, and there is. But interestingly enough, though, like, you know, a lot of other foods, the exact origin of ice cream is pretty much unknown. Now, when I did a little bit of research, what we do know, I have found, is that the origin of ice cream likely dates back to AD 54 to 68, during the time when Nero was the Emperor of Rome. Please don't quote me on that, because I did so much yes, no, that is correct. That is correct. And evidence shown harvesting ice or snow, and then they flavored it with honey or other flavorings to make a form of ice cream. And Alexander the Great supposedly enjoyed icy drinks that had flavors such as honey or nectar too. Now, the first appearance, this is what I thought was interesting. The first appearance of ice cream in the U.S. is found in a letter by Maryland Governor William Bladen in 1744. Early presidents also had a liking towards ice cream. In fact, in the summer of 1790, George Washington spent approximately $200 for ice cream. You know, for a while, you know, at that time and at the beginning of the, you know, when ice cream was introduced into the U.S., it was like more of a fancy treat. It was pretty much known for the rich. You know, the rich could have that. But then in 1843, Nancy Johnson patented the first hand crank ice cream maker. Now, 8 years after that, in 1851, Jacob Fussell built the first ice cream factory. And those inventions, you know, made it much easier to produce ice cream and spread it out to the masses, you know? In fact, the invention of mechanical refrigeration, which was a huge one, of course, if you're making ice cream, really, really, really made it happen at that time. So, I thought that was kind of interesting because I wondered, like, where ice cream, like, how did it come to the U.S.? What was it at the beginning, you know? And we have some fun facts, too, about ice cream. I mean, ice cream is just fun. I'm sorry. Talk about something fun. Ice cream. Ice cream makes me smile. I go through these periods where, like, I have cravings for ice cream. And I'm the kind that likes plain old chocolate ice cream or, like, the ice cream that has, like, the kitchen sink in it, you know? Candy and cookies and ribbons of fudge and peanut butter. I love it all. I have to say, ice cream is my weakness. It is. And here are some fun facts. Vanilla ice cream is the most popular flavor of ice cream all over the world. Now, here in America, Americans consume about 23 gallons per year, each person on average. 23 gallons each person a year on average. That's something else. The ice cream soda was invented in 1874, and an average size ice cream cone, it takes roughly 50 licks to finish it. Now, I wonder who did that, you know? I don't know. And it says here, now that's an average. I guess it does decide, you know, the deciding factor would be how big your ice cream cone is, I think, really. And California produces the most ice cream in all of the United States. National Ice Cream Month is in July. President Ronald Reagan designated July as National Ice Cream Month. And along with that, the third Sunday of July is National Ice Cream Day, which is this Sunday coming up. And another interesting fact about that is that there's over 1,200 national days. I'm just having a blast looking them up, too. There is a national day for every day of the year and several on each day. It's crazy. Oh, my gosh. So, I think that's about it for some interesting facts about ice cream, you know. This is kind of cool. I mean, you know, we all know that ice cream, you know, historically has been like a key feature in American communities. I mean, I don't personally know anybody who like hates ice cream, but I would think that it's a staple in American cuisine. But according to a recent survey, most ice cream companies today are family-owned and have been in operation for more than 50 years. As a matter of fact, even just recently in the last couple years, we've seen so many more smaller ice creameries that are family-owned or, well, just small niche ice cream companies kind of take root and get a little bit bigger, you know. It's much easier to distribute product now in the United States. So some of those smaller ice cream shops and all that, you know, they're able to distribute their ice cream a lot easier now. And I so dig trying all those. I think, like, around here we have some new brands called Nick's and, well, even like Häagen-Dazs and that, they have those smaller gourmet ice creams. They have all those crazy flavors. I love trying all those. I really do. But here's something here. It also, you know, in a time that our economy here is kind of, I don't know, a little unsteady right now, ice cream itself helps support the U.S. economy, contributing more than $11 billion directly to the national economy every year. That's a lot of money. Like, that's crazy. I don't know. All right, well, let me put this away. You know me and my trivial, interesting facts. I don't know. I find it interesting. I hope you did too. But anyway, so like I said, tonight, I'm really, really excited to share this recipe with you. I've been making this, I don't even know how long, for years I've been making this. And like, if you make this and like you serve it to your guests, they're gonna be so surprised because It really is quite impressive. And when you tell them that you made it yourself, they're not going to believe it, because this recipe turns out so cool and so nice, and it's so versatile. And I could go on and on and on and on, you know, like I usually do, but I'm not going to. Why don't we go right into the kitchen and make this up, all right? All right, let's go do it. Okay. Okay, so here we are in the kitchen, and we're about ready to make our ice cream cake. I'm so excited. Oh my gosh. Okay. We'll get to the ingredients later. First of all, what you're going to need is a pan. Now, this recipe, you can make it into a 9x13 or a quarter sheet cake. You can even do little individual ones if you'd like. But if you're following along exactly in this recipe, we are going to make it in a 9-inch round pan. So I would suggest getting a 9-inch round springform pan, because it makes it a little bit easier. Now, a little tip for the springform pan, like, if you use them as much as I use them, they start to get a little bit loose, and sometimes they can leak, okay? Just put a little bit of tin foil around the bottom, just like that, and you will be set to go, all right? So you'll need that, and, okay, let's get to the ingredients. Okay, so for this recipe, you are going to need, well, obviously, ice cream. And this recipe is so versatile, I think that the funnest part of this whole recipe is choosing what flavors to use. You'll find yourself in the grocery store looking at all the flavors of ice cream, and you can't pick which one because you don't know what to pick. Oh my gosh. So anyway, after many hours of deliberation, I went with Turkey Hills Peanut Butter Ripple Ice Cream. Oh yeah, this is going to be so delicious. So you're going to want 1/2 gallon of ice cream of your choice, and you're going to let that set out for about an hour or two, just so it gets to be a little bit soft. Not like water, but just soft, if you know what I mean. So in addition to that, we are going to need 1 tub of Cool Whip whipped frosting, okay? Any kind, you like the extra creamy, grab that. You can even use light if you're worried about calories there, okay? All right, there's a few more ingredients we'll need. Let's go figure it out. Okay, so in addition to that, you're also going to need something to make a crust out of. And again, like I said, this is very versatile. You can pick whatever you want. Graham cracker crumbs. Today, since we're going to be using peanut butter ripple ice cream, I'm going to use Nutter Butter cookies for the crust. And I'm going to stir some in as a little mix-in surprise as well. Now, I did get the family size here, but you only need to have the regular size package to make one cake, all right? I have about, I don't know, 8 left in there. So what I did was, in a regular size package, you're going to leave about 5 or 6 cookies and then just kind of break them up like that. And the rest of it, you're going to process in a food processor into crumbs like that. Now, never fear if you do not have a food processor. You can always take a Ziploc bag and a rolling pin and make your own crumbs. Sometimes I choose to do it this way because it gets my frustrations out. You know what I'm saying? All right, now, so in addition to that, you'll also need about 1/3 cup of butter, which I have melted in the microwave until it's nice and soft like that, okay? So what we're going to do is we're going to make a crust by pouring the butter into our crumbs. Any kind of crumbs you use, if you use chocolate crumbs, peanut butter crumbs, graham cracker crumbs, anything. And we're just going to stir this until it's incorporated just a little bit here, all right? And really, that's pretty good. Oh, gosh, adding butter to Nutter Butters. Can it possibly get any better? Oh, my gosh. Well, it can, actually. All right, so that's pretty good. So now we're going to get our pan, and we're going to put just about all of it in there. Spread it all around. And I'm going to save, let's see, I'm going to save just about 1 tablespoon. We're going to use that a little bit later to garnish the top of it. And now the fun part. You're going to push it down, forming a crust at the bottom, just like so. And that's all you need, just like that. Okay, so now we're going to set that aside, and let's check our ice cream. Hopefully it's ready to go. Ah, perfect. Yes, it's totally ready to go. All right, So, I saw that. Alright. So, we're going to pour this into our mixer. Now, if you don't have a stand mixer, that's okay. You can also use a hand mixer, and you can actually do this by hand, too. And I'll explain that in a second. No big deal if you don't have a stand mixer. If you do, make sure that you have your paddle attachment on, okay? And make sure you get all that yummy goodness. Yes, you got to. Okay, perfect. And then in addition to that, you're going to add your tub of Cool Whip. Now, if you want to, you could also use heavy cream. There we go, just like so. And make your own whipped cream as well. Just add a little bit of sugar and vanilla to it, and you will be set. Okay. All right. Let me get this out of the way here. And now, as you can guess, we are just going to... Whoops, I guess I should raise it, huh? And we're just going to mix it on low speed until it's all incorporated. Just folding it all together. You're not going to whip it. We're not going to beat it. We just want to blend it together. A little bit more than a fold, but much less than a blend, if you know what I'm saying. And that is perfect. All right. Now, like I said, you can do that with an electric mixer, too. And you can also do that by hand using just a regular spatula. Make sure you get all that goodness. Okay. Woo, yummy, 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 yummy. I'll lick that up later. See? Oh. All right, that's exactly the consistency you want. Now we're going to add a little surprise in there. Oh, yeah. Because why the heck not, right? Okay. All right, now as you guessed, guess where this goes. Oh, yeah. Just like so. And I know I keep saying that this is versatile, and it is. For example, you could use however many flavors of ice cream you'd like. You can also layer them too. Like if you wanted to do a banana split, you would use chocolate, vanilla, and strawberry ice cream. You just want to make sure that each layer gets frozen before you set the next layer on it. If that makes sense. I hope that makes sense. We'll talk about that more later. Okay, smooth out the top a little bit, and just for show, that tablespoon or so of crumbs, just put a little bit on top like so. Just like that. Oh yeah, oh my gosh, I cannot wait to eat this, I just can't. Okay, and we are good to go. Okay, so now that's ready to go. We're going to pop this into the freezer, and we're going to freeze it until it is solid. Now, you know, home refrigerators, I don't know. The freezers just aren't as great. Now, I have worked in a professional restaurant for actually most of my life, and I'm used to the professional freezers. You could actually pop them in for like an hour or two, and it's perfect. But at home, our freezers, it's going to take a long time because you do want that to freeze solid. So I would suggest leaving it in for at least 8 hours or overnight. I'm leaving mine in overnight. But through the magic of TV, I just happen to have one finished for you that I cut up and put on plates, so let's show you. This flavor that I made, and if you remember, it was for last Mondays with Mark, this flavor was sweet bourbon. Oh my gosh, and there it is, and there's the slice. And it is absolutely delicious. I needed a dessert that went with a Southern-themed dinner, so we went with I think it was called Kentucky Sweet Bourbon Ice Cream by Turkey Hill, and I used a graham cracker crust on this one. All made exactly the same way, and that's how it turned out. Oh, gosh, it's so, so delicious. So what I'll do is, once that freezes, I'll definitely show you on this Mondays with Marc. I'll show you how it turned out. And, of course, I will post it on Facebook, too, so you can print it out if you want to make it yourself, too. Now, another nice thing about these is you can decorate these any way you want by adding some gemmies, you know, or pearls or any type of decorations. You can even get some store-bought frosting and decorate it like a regular birthday cake or an anniversary cake. You can even write happy birthday on it if you want. I think that would be very nice to bring to a birthday party. So, oh, well, looks like we're starting to melt, so I guess I better take care of that. And, well, by that I mean eating it. But anyway, guys, thank you so, so much for watching. I had a blast making this with you. I hope you give this a try yourself. This weekend would be perfect for it since it's so hot here. Anyway, make sure you check us out over on Facebook at Smokey Steve Space and Marc. Again, I will post this there so you can print it out if you want to try it. We're also on Instagram at SmokeySteveAndMarc. We're also on Twitter. Our handle is SmokeySteveA. All of our contact information is listed below. You know, our address, our email address. And please, 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 if you would be so kind, hit that subscribe button and hit the notification bell so you'll be the first to know whenever we put out a new video, okay? Remember, everybody, please stay safe, stay well. But above all else, stay positive. I'll see you next time.